Hi friends, a very good morning. Since we last spoke, it has been quite a ride in the financial markets. Dollar has gone from 53 levels, in fact from levels of 5280 to all the way up to now 56.5, and it's threatening to make a new all-time high against the Indian rupee. There have been a number of events over the last 4 to 6 weeks. There's been elections in Greece. There has been the Federal Reserve meeting, which happened yesterday. And there's also been political issues in India, and also the risk of deficient monsoon is rising by the day. So all this has kept the pressure on the Indian rupee, and we believe that over the next 4 to 6 weeks, there is a possibility that Indian rupee might even head to its 57 and higher. Now the question is, what can take this? What can help the Indian rupee to take this path? Initially, we believe the Eurozone problem is not solved. You have heard about this problem for the last three years. Every time there is a possibility that some particular country is able to solve the problem, a new issue comes into the forefront, and the Greece is has been able to form a government, but we don't believe that the Greek story is over, because the debt problem in Greece is going to continue in the days ahead. In Eurozone, if we break down the issues, we would come to three key problem areas where we can concentrate on. The first, if we look at countries in the Southern Europe, they have too much of debt on their on the government's books. They have too much of debt on the bank's books. So a solution would be to reduce that debt. The question is, can they create austerity and pay down that debt? No, it is simply not working, because over the last 1.5 years, they have tried the austerity measures across various countries in the Eurozone. But the very fact that austerity is causing the economic growth to slow down, and as a result of which countries in the Southern Europe are in a deep recession. So it's like the GDP itself is contracting. So if GDP continues to contract, their ability to pay the already huge debt is shrinking by the day. So we believe, until unless they are able to address the issue of high debt and shrinking economy, this problem will keep surfacing. And ultimately, the banks in the Eurozone, which are substantially large compared to the banks in the other parts of the world, their linkages with the economy is also quite significant. So if Eurozone economy is going to slow down, if the countries in the Eurozone is going to face problems to pay down their debt, the banks in the Eurozone will continue to have problems. So that's quite economic logic which flows. So we believe, going forward to the next 4 to 6 weeks, Euro dollar, though it might have some upsides in the short term, thanks to the US Fed, who has said that possibility of further printing of money to help the market is there. But we believe that upside in the euro would be limited. So something like 1.28, 1.30 could be where the euro, if it is able to rally, could get stuck, and finally it might come down towards 1.2 over the next 1 month or 2 months. Coming to the other currencies, the GBP dollar, we believe GBP will continue to outperform the euro, because UK, the luxury it has is of a currency which is different from the Eurozone. So with a country with a separate currency has a lot more flexibility. So that is what UK is enjoying. So as a result of which, we believe GBP will continue to outperform the euro. And coming to dollar yen, yesterday we had seen that the Japanese trade balance is now flipped into the deficit territory. So Japan, which was a substantial exporter, is now becoming a net importer. Though we believe this is a one-off thing and it will correct back to a trade surplus, but the tendency with which this the balance has shrunk over the last few months, and in fact 1 year is definitely not good thing for the yen. But still, we believe that if the risk aversion continues in the global markets, then yen would benefit, which means the dual forces of worsening macros in Japan, which makes the yen, which creates a downward pressure on the yen, and the risk aversion in the world, which creates an upward pressure on the yen, would keep the dollar yen ranged. Possibly 78 to 81 could be the range in the dollar yen, say over the next 1 month or so. And coming to the dollar rupee, once again, as we said, we believe that possibility of a depreciation exists. The only trend which we think can reverse the depletion trend in the currency is if central bank of America or the ECB or the People Bank of China, if either of these three major central banks of the world announce a surprising measures to print money into the system. Like, for example, if ECB announces another LTRO as it did in the beginning of the year, or Federal Reserve announces a measure to launch the QE3, means complete monetization of the assets. Those kind of things will definitely create a short-term downtrend in the dollar. Otherwise, considering that the monsoon looks to be deficient, at least to start with, and there is still policy gridlock which is continuing, we believe that Indian rupee, the trend is still downward. So thank you.